The Yau Mathematical Science Center is housed in an elegant and quiet Jingzhai building at Tsinghua University. The center is named after the eminent Chinese-American mathematician Shing-Tung Yau and also serves as his personal office. In 1976, Shing-Tung Yau achieved a monumental breakthrough by proving the Calabi conjecture, a development that both transformed the field of mathematics and established a new area of geometric analysis. At the age of 33, he was awarded the Fields Medal, often regarded as the Nobel Prize in mathematics. He has since won numerous other major international awards in mathematics. In 2009, at the invitation of Tsinghua University, Yau, then chair of the Harvard Mathematics Department, founded the Yau Mathematical Science Center, Tsinghua University, and assumed its directorship.
It's a great pleasure to talk with you, Professor Yau. You have had extensive interactions with students from both Chinese and American universities. What differences and similarities do you notice in their talents?
Well, they behave rather differently. The American students are much more casual. They will call me Yau in most cases instead of Professor Yau. Because they are more casual, they will talk about many things that they have in mind, which they want to do. And they tend to be more brave in exploring new areas in science and technology. Well, for Chinese students, they are more hesitant in asking questions, and they study very hard, on the other hand, in classes. They will listen, and they will do homeworks, and they try to excel in examinations and all that.
Compared to the past, how has the environment and the development of China's basic research changed in recent years?
Well, fundamental science is extremely important for modern technology, especially science, creative part of science. In the last 10 years, I think the Chinese government, the leaders of China, realized the importance of putting investment into basic science. And I see that they have expanded rapidly, especially there are many graduate students coming back from overseas, and some faculty from universities in America are coming to China.
In recent years, the rapid advancement in artificial intelligence has been fueled by dramatic increases in computing power and the vast data accumulation. AI's capabilities are continually evolving, promising even greater possibilities in the future. The just concluded third plenary session of the 20th Central Committee of the Communist Party of China called for efforts to boost China's strength in strategic science and technology. It emphasized to better define the roles and layout of national research institutions, advanced-level research universities, and leading high-tech enterprises, and basic research.
How do you think the rapid development will impact the exploration of the cutting-edge mathematical fields?
What they have accomplished is already amazing, and I think it will change the industry and even some research in mathematics on basic science. We are hoping to see that it will give very constructive improvement in all these fields. But AI itself, to science, is still not clear, although they are making contributions. Partly because AI needs much more fundamental science for input. Right now, AI has involved huge number of computations. The number of parameters is, we are talking about trillions of parameters and all that. I don't think a good system should need that many parameters. So I think there are much rooms to be improved to understand AI, to make it much more important, much more efficient.
What opportunities do you see for international cooperation between China and other countries in this field?
I think in order to facilitate global cooperation, what China should do is to produce some creative technology, putting what is new in AI. But I don't think that the way that the AI is being developed in China now is thinking about how to create new steps. What they are thinking is how to catch up what we are missing. So learning from others is extremely important, of course. But to move in our own way is also important. Now, only after that, I think we could see an equal ground to cooperate.
You have been actively promoting international youth exchanges and organizing various domestic and international research projects to foster cross-cultural understanding and cooperation. The global youth are encouraged to address common mathematical challenges together. How do these exchanges contribute to creating a multicultural environment and enhancing students' global competence?
We have invited many famous researchers to come from America, from England, from France, from Russia, to China. When they met our students in Chiu-Tung College, they were amazed how good the students are. And in fact, we have sent our students to America, to England, to France, and they are welcomed by them. They are very happy to welcome them. And vice versa, their own students from Harvard, from Princeton, from Stanford, from MIT, they actually come to China together. They even play basketball together just a few days ago in Xinhua campus. And I think it's a very friendly exchange between these students from America and from China. The friendship is here, that there's young students like each other. And I think we will push this kind of friendship on and on so that we understand each other better.
You often cite traditional Chinese culture as a key source of your spiritual strength and cultural confidence. Tsinghua University's motto, self-discipline and social commitment, embodies a deep connection to Chinese traditional values. How does Chinese traditional culture motivate your mathematical research? And how should contemporary young mathematicians and math students draw inspiration from it?
The Chinese tradition will tell us to be more patient, and we should try to train ourselves to learn how to deal with hardship. We learn a great deal from our ancient teaching. Some of that we learned when we were in high school or even earlier in primary school. This kind of learning, I think, is very important. So you see, the Chinese students go abroad, they are able to sustain their effort to finally succeed, which is not so easy. And also, our culture looks at nature in many different ways. So we try to learn how to deal with the environment, and then we can try to appreciate the beauty of what nature can give to us. And this is very important for scientists.
The second International Congress of Basic Science was held in Beijing from July 14th to 26th. Over 800 scientists and scholars from around the world gathered to discuss pioneering advancements in basic science and explore future development orientations. Professor Shing-Tung Yau, along with other Fields Medal and Turing Awards winners, shared their experiences and insights at the event.
I think we are contributing to the development of basic science for the whole world, not just for China. And besides that, we create an environment that people understand China better. After they come, they talk with us, and they also travel around a little bit. They understand China in the first-hand way. And they know that our students are good, and our researchers are friendly, and everybody will be happy to see this environment. And I believe this will facilitate and promote the cooperation between China and America and European countries.